And welcome in, everybody. Glad you're with us. MLB The Show has Interleague action for you this afternoon. It's the Arizona Diamondbacks taking on the Seattle Mariners. First pitch coming your way next. All right, first pitch coming up. And towing the slab, Chris Flexen. And Singy, it's unique these days, but he's more of a pitch-to-contact type of guy.
Yeah, Boogie, he doesn't rely too heavily on the strikeout. He knows he needs to miss barrels, get some soft contact, let the defense do work behind him. And I think a guy like that can keep a good tempo, don't give hitters time to adjust or think. They can move through a ball game, and you look off, they're in line for a quality start. We'll see what he's got in this one.
And a foul ball.
First pitch, 110.
Next offering is in for a strike. Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock.
Batting second. The
Alec Thomas now.
Alec Thomas.
And that's in there for strike one. Rojas gets his lead at first. Nobody out. Next offering is in for a strike.
I got the count 0 and 2.
Ground ball could be two. Off balance feed, there's one. Over to first, safe.
That is third. The designated hitter, Ketel Marte.
Here's Ketel Marte.
Good speed on the base pass. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or run and hit.
And a pitch. That's in for a strike.
Looks like he's just sizing him up there. Really good pitch to hit, but he took it all the way. Sometimes guys just want to set their timing later on in the game. That may be a pitch that he turns on.
Next one is off the plate. 2-1.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
The 2-1. Hit hard. That gets through. Rodriguez to third.
Absolutely hammered that baseball. Very loud coming off the bat. 107 was the exit velocity, and at that speed, it's going to be a great result more often than not.
And now it's Christian Walker. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Runners are at the corners, one away. Next one off the plate inside. Ball two. The pitch. Oh, right to the backstop. But all the runners hold. And a pitch. And that'll load the bases.
Now that sets up a really big at bat in this game. These are the moments when everyone in the stadium gets really locked in.
David Peralta at the plate. First offering misses the mark. The 1-0. Bounce to third. Lays out. Oh, it's off his glove. To first, and he beats it. Everyone's safe.
Always feels amazing getting a job done when the team needs you to come through. It's just bigger than your own individual stats. That's one of those you classify as just too hot to handle. Hit it on the screws, and it couldn't be fielded cleanly, but you can't really blame the defense in that case. Now the base is loaded. Big opportunity for them to break this game open.
And now it's Dalton Varsho. First pitch, and he just misses.
Well, he's so good about trying to drive the ball to the opposite field gap in these situations. If he takes that approach, he could bust this game wide open.
One out, base is full. Line drive to short and caught. Puts the tag on him, and that's the inning. Bottom half of inning number one coming up. It's the Diamondbacks 1 and the Mariners nothing. Bottom of the first, and starting in this one, Merrill Kelly. What should we keep an eye on here?
Well, he's putting together a really nice season on the mound. ERA in the low threes. Very respectable when you consider guys are looking to do damage. They're not trying to just walk and hit singles. They're trying to hit homers and draw walks and score runs. So when you have a guy that can limit the other team from scoring more than a few runs, that's really tough to beat game in and game out.
And stepping in for the Mariners, Julio Rodriguez. Rodriguez having a really nice first season in the big leagues. Definitely a rookie of the year candidate. And the first pitch misses for ball one. And here it comes. Out front and foul to the left side. Hit in the air, right field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one away. And now we check out the Mariners lineup. Batting second, a really important guy for them. Ty France.
Well, he's an important part of this lineup for sure. I mean, there's no doubt about it, but somebody that they try to feed off of. He does a lot of things, you know, very well up there at the plate. He's got a presence about him, and you know, he's a guy that you really kind of like to watch swing the bat.
In now is the Mariners DH, Ty France. That's a laser base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
All over that one right there. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make them pay.
Here's Jesse Winker. First offering, and it just misses. And the 1-0. Oh, now this is blasted way back there on its way. Gone. A two-run homer. It's his eighth home run of the year. It's 2-1. Chris, that ball came out hot. So let's see what StatCast has to say.
Yeah, it really did, Boog. 111 miles per hour off the bat, and a really nice launch angle as well. Just a beautiful swing from start to finish.
And now it's the switch hitter, Carlos Santana.
Batting four. The first baseman.
That one's in there, 0-1.
Santana.
Still only one out here in the inning. The pitch. Foul ball. One down, base is empty. That one way outside. And the count is 1-2. And a ground ball to first. And he takes it himself for the out.
Batting fifth, the third baseman, Eugenio.
Hey, Eugenio Suarez up to the plate now. And first offering is fouled off. Two outs. And it's 1-1.
Good purpose pitch right there. Trying to tease him, get him to raise his sights, pop something up, and make it an easy out.
That's to third. Oh, and it hits the base. And that is that. Two come in on this Seattle homer. And this is now a 2-1 ball game. Top of the second. Now it's the second baseman, Sergio Alcantara.
Leading off for the Diamondbacks, the second baseman.
Well, after Sergio putting up a nice inning on offense, Alcantara got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
Next pitch is outside.
Boog, one of our favorites, Jerry Hillsdale umpiring behind home plate in this one. Pretty much by the book with his strike zone.
And because he's so by the book, you'll sometimes see pitchers questioning him. They'll make a good pitch on the edge of the zone, want the strike, and not get the call. But most of the time, Jerry gets it right. He's a good one. Singy, what kind of strike zone is most frustrating for hitters?
I'd say off the plate, away, and down. And why? Those are the toughest locations to hit the baseball.
That one drilled left field, and he makes the catch. And there's one down.
Batting it, the shortstop, Geraldo.
Here's
Perdomo.
A speed threat, Geraldo Perdomo. As the game has moved along, we see more and more information supplied by teams about the umpires. I've been in clubhouses where they have pictures of all four guys, nicknames, hometowns, and as well hobbies listed, just so you can kind of small talk the umpire a little bit.
That's great.
The catcher, number 36, Jose Herrera.
Two outs, base is empty. Now up next for Arizona, Jose Herrera. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Here's a 1-1. Good eye right there.
The count is 2-1.
The wind of the pitch. This one high in the air to left center. Rodriguez settles under this one. Makes the play, and it's out number three. And the Diamondbacks down in order. They're down 2-1. Back at T-Mobile Park, here's the shortstop at the play, J.P. Crawford.
For the Mariners, the shortstop, J.P. Crawford.
Why to kick the pitch. And that's outside. And the pitch. And now 2-0. Righty to the plate. Ground ball right side. And he handles it himself for the out.
Batting seven. The catcher, Cal Raleigh.
Cal Raleigh up next for the Mariners. I'm gonna take you down. First pitch just misses. The 1-0. Now a rocket to right center. Way back there. And forget it. It's out of here. That one felt good. His 14th of the year. It's 3-1.
Low 90s fastball, you have to live on the edges and hit your spots. If you don't, you'll get hit hard. Really good swing there. Patient, waited for it. It was like BP all over again.
Here's Adam Frazier.
Batting it. The second baseman, Adam.
First offering, misses the mark. Pitch. That one's in there, and it's 1-1. The pitch. That misses, and it's 2-1. That one the other way, and that should be extra bases. Around first, digging for two, and it kicks off the base of the wall. And he starts his afternoon off right with a double.
A couple of hits in a row for him here. That was exactly what you're looking to do with the pitch away, especially in that situation, driving it to the opposite field gap. Got himself two bags on a great swing of the bat.
Sam Haggerty now at the plate.
Batting ninth, the right fielder, Sam Haggerty.
First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Frazier leads off second with one gone in the inning. Next offering misses, and it's a ball and a strike. And it's second. And there's a foul ball. At the belt and fires. Out to short. Dives and he can't hang on. He doesn't have a throw. And the speedy runner is on at first.
The center fielder.
Back to the top of the lineup. Here's the center fielder, Julio Rodriguez. 0-for-1, he was robbed of a hit on a diving catch his first time up.
He's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion and he's in full speed.
Swings and lines a base hit into left field. Peralta fires it to the plate. It's offline, and he scores. And they lead by three.
Four hits in a row, and they're really swinging it here. Nice line drive to the full side, fed it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
Next to hit, Ty France. 1-for-1. He singled to left his first time through.
The designated hitter, Tom.
First offering, and it just misses. Runners at first and second with one gone. Next pitch misses inside, and the count is 2-0. On the ground, could be two. Off balance speed, there's one. And that's two. We played two full. It's the Mariners four and the Diamondbacks one. Top half of the third inning. Here's the Diamondbacks leadoff hitter, Josh Rojas.
Leading off for Arizona.
The D-backs in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. I need a good at bat out of him right here.
The wind of the pitch. Up the middle. That's a base hit. And the leadoff man aboard.
The center fielder, number five.
So up next, Alec Thomas. Thomas having a lot more success on the road this season.
Strike him out.
Check on the runner. Rojas back in on a dive. First pitch, and he just misses.
Well, the offense has gotten going, and a pitcher wants to go out there, have a real quick inning, get those guys back into the dugout so those bats can stay hot.
Nobody out. Runner at first. Next pitch misses, and now 2-0.
No, he's really working him away this at bat. Sometimes take a little bit off velocity. Try to get a rollover, something on the ground. Stay away from that big hole on the right side of the infield.
And a pitch. Misses with the 2-0, and he's fired three straight outside the strike zone. Oh, this ball is crushed into left field. It's on its way and gone. With one swing, he quiets the crowd. It's his eighth home run of the year. It's 4-3.
Knew what pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
Ketel Marte up to the plate.
Now batting, designated hitter, Ketel.
Can be tough to bounce back after a big home run, but nobody on, nobody out. You just have to treat it as a fresh inning.
Drive, and that's base hit out into center field.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. These days, when you see a ball come off the bat like that, the first thing you want to know as a spectator, what was the exit velocity? 109 in this case. I mean, that's just impressive, and it's so cool we can get that sort of feedback so instantly in today's game.
Christian Walker stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Oh, this one high and deep, way back there. Out of here. He blasts one out to center. His 21st of the year, and they add a pair. It's 5-4.
Well, he went up there 0-0 looking to do damage. I think he had his sight set on that pitch. He went and got it and circled the bases.
And here is David Peralta.
Now batting, the left fielder, David.
Nice grab.
Peralta.
Clearly stole a base hit right there. Excellent job. Great athleticism by the shortstop to make that leaping catch to bring it down. It was a line drive headed for the outfield.
Next to hit for Arizona, Dalton Varsho. He's 0-for-1. in there, and it's 0-1. Next pitch, not close, up high.
Clearly, he hasn't had it in this game, and looks like sooner than later, they're going to have to go to the bullpen.
Lined into right, and that's a base hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
Looked around that pitch on the outside, but he was still able to square it up pretty nicely. And that takes quick, strong wrist to pull that off.
And now it's the switch hitting second baseman, Sergio Alcantara. In there for strike one. Varsho leads off first with one away.
He's going. The kick and the pitch.
Runner goes. It's a pitch out. Throw to second. Tag. And they got him. Next offering is in for a strike. Swing and a high fly ball down the left field line, but hooking foul. One, two now. Line drive caught. But the long ball was working in this inning. Not once, but twice. It's down to one at 5-4. Back here at the ballpark, set for the bottom of the third, and now for Seattle, Jesse Winker.
Mariners, no left fielder. Jesse Winker.
It's been a rough start on the mound for this guy. His third inning is so important for him to get on track, turn the page, settle in, do all those things you need to do to give your team a little bit of length in this one. Well, I think this is an important inning on the mound for him in this game. He's got to find a way to settle things down and give some length in this start.
Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. Rojas racing over to make the catch.
Up next for Seattle, the first baseman,
Carlos Santana. Up next for the Mariners. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
This is a very important inning here. After scoring all those runs, you want your pitcher to come out and just mow them down. The offense has worked hard. It's shut down inning time.
And the 1-0. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul. The pitch. On the ground, right side. Perdomo handles the chance. And a couple of quick outs.
Up next for Seattle, the third baseman, Eugenio.
Two outs, bases empty. Now the third baseman, Eugenio Suarez.
This is important. If he can go 1-2-3 here, will be a very positive sign for him and for his team.
And that's in there for strike one. Kicks and deals. That one misses, and the count is 1-1. Here comes a pitch. Now this one is hammered way back there. On its way and gone, and we are tied. Eugenio Suarez blasts one out, and we're level. It's 5-5.
That hanger, and pitchers typically don't get away with making a mistake like that. And right there, he made him pay.
J.P. Crawford gets a chance to hit. 0-for-1. He grounded out to first his last time.
Shortstop, J.P.
First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Crawford.
Righty delivers. That misses the zone. 2-0. A wind in the pitch. That one inside, and now 3-0. Tied up here in the early going. Next pitch in for a strike, 3-1.
Back-to-back fastballs in. That last one called for a strike. Probably go away, but look for him to come back in there to try to finish you off.
Line drive, makes the catch, and a goal. Solo homer gets the M's even in this one. All even at 5 apiece. Right now, right down, write your feelings out loud. Write a song loud, put my words in style. Find out why my people are crying out. Reach out with hip-hop, skateboard, Instagram. Dance if you want to. Out of the fourth, and the batter will be the shortstop, Geraldo Perdomo.
Leading off for the Diamondbacks, the shortstop.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
There's the strike. And the righty deals. That one blasted deep to right. That's back there. And that one is going to go. Third home run of the season. Just like that, they move in front. It's 6-5.
That's exactly the pitch he was looking for. Crushes it and hits it out of the ballpark.
And now it's going to be Jose Herrera. 0-for-1 with a flyout.
The catcher, number 36.
First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
Oh, you just got to delete it. You give up that leadoff home run, go back to work, focus on this next batter.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, he didn't like those first two pitches. Now in an 0-2 hole, he's going to have to battle. Hope he gets a mistake. One guy that was really great once the count got to two strikes, Miguel Cabrera.
In the air, left field. Winker ranging back. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one away.
Now battle. Third baseman, Josh.
So the batting Rojas. Order turns over. Josh Rojas stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Check swing to the first pitch. Look down to third, and that's going to be ruled a swing. Next offering down low and in the dirt. There's a swing and a drive. And that ball is out of here. He leaves the yard to right, and they add a run. It's 7-5.
A good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
And here comes the Mariners manager to the mound, pitching change coming. Chris Flexen done for the afternoon. We'll be back in a minute with a new arm on the mound. So out of the bullpen for the Mariners, number 67. He's into the game with the bases empty.
At this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
One out, bases empty. Alec Thomas getting ready to hit.
Alec Thomas.
First offering misses the mark. And he deals just off the outside edge. That one's spoiled, and the count now 2-1.
Well, he got challenged with a good fastball right there. Just couldn't catch up.
Here's a 2-1. Sliced hard, but foul. The 2-2. Swings and misses, and there's two away.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way, but that time, a little anxious.
Designated hitter.
Two outs, bases empty. An outstanding hitter in Ketel Marte. First pitch, not close. Kicks and fires.
Two ball, no strike.
That one pulled foul. Two one down. Swing and a ball hammered left field. That's back there, and it hits the fence. It's a double, third hit of the night for him.
Having himself a really nice game at the plate. Anytime you smoke a ball off the wall, you kind of think about what it could have been, but obviously you have to be happy with that result.
And it's scored position with two away. And now, Christian Walker. In there, and it's 0-1.
The strategy of winning a ball game, when you could make that pitcher work a little more, expose himself by throwing pitches, that could be the key to winning perhaps later on. So good job of extending this inning, getting a knock with two outs to bring the number four hole hitter up.
Man on second, two down. And it's even up. And the right-hander deals. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Two outs and one in scoring position. Swing and a miss, and that is that. But the long ball was working in this inning. Not once, but twice. It's now 7-5. I got nothing. And welcome back. Bottom four, here's the catcher, Cal Raleigh.
Leading up for the Mariners, the catcher, Cal Raleigh.
And a pitch. Ball one, no strikes.
Ball one, no strikes.
And a foul ball.
That fastball at the bottom of the zone can be very effective. Just got to keep it on the corners.
And here it comes. That one is upstairs.
Two ball, one strike.
The pitch. on the ground to first. Takes it himself, and one gone to the fourth as they get the leadoff man.
Up next is the second baseman, Adam Frazier.
Here's the second baseman, Adam Frazier. First offering misses badly for ball one. There's a strike.
One ball, one strike.
Frazier checks his swing. Appeal down to third, and he held back, according to Rusty Valentine. Right-hander kicks, deals. Strike two.
Two balls, two strikes.
Left-hand batter waits. Breaking ball inside. And a full count now. The pitch. Out there to center. Thomas settles underneath it. And there's two down.
Now batting. Right fielder. Sam Haggerty.
Sam Haggerty up next for the Mariners. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
Counts 1-0.
Two outs.
Two balls, no strikes.
Check swing, but he went too far. And that's strike one. And a pitch. Well struck right field. And it hits the base of the wall. And he's in at second with a two-out double.
Nice double right there. Loud contact coming off the bat. Didn't get enough air under to drive it out of here, but you'll take that swing and that result every time.
So two down now, and here is Julio Rodriguez. He's already singled in this game.
Julio.
And that one fouled off. The pitch. And there's the strike. Tying run at the plate. Went too far that time. It's 1-2.
Well, he missed badly with that 0-2 fastball. Hitter has to understand. Probably wants to try to put him away with that pitch. So got to stay ready for it.
Runner at second. Two down. Next pitch is popped up. Puts the squeeze on it. And that is that. One left for Seattle. They're down two. 7-5. Back in Seattle, now the left fielder, David Peralta.
Leading off for the Diamondbacks, the left fielder, David Peralta.
Pitch. That one's in there. It's 0-1. Action in the pen down there. Number 53, the veteran southpaw, is getting ready to come on if needed. Number 56, getting loose as well. Next offering is in the dirt. Right-handed reliever. Fly ball down the line. Flashes the leather on the running catch. One up, one down.
The right fielder, number 12, Dalton Varsho.
Next up for the Diamondbacks, Dalton Varsho, 1-2. First pitch just misses. Up the middle, Crawford handles. Throws to first, and the first two set down in the top of the fifth.
Now batting, the second baseman, Sergio Alcantara.
Now it's the second baseman, Sergio Alcantara. That hits the dirt, and that's ball one.
Ball one, no strikes.
Righty to the plate. Well struck left field. And it's off the wall. Relay throw to second, but he's in there easily.
Drove that ball nicely, put a great swing on it, and it jumped off his bat. Kind of put it all together there, and he's rewarded with the double.
Hard on the ground to first. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. One left for Arizona. They lead it 7-5. Welcome back. John Schaube with my buddy Chris Singleton. It's set to get us started. Bottom five. Ty France.
The designated hitter. John.
Kelly back to work. That's in there. The 0-1. Alcantara. Over to first. And a quick out, number one.
Now batting, left fielder, Jesse Winker.
Jesse Winker up next for the Mariners. 1-2 with a two-run homer back in the first. First pitch, and he just misses. The 1-0. That's outside.
No, that pitch not even close. A 2-0 count now. He can't be over aggressive. He's got to make sure that pitch is right on a tee for him.
Righty delivers.
That's ball three.
There's a strike.
That fastball, even though it's up, that's the velocity you want to go after. Low 90s, a lot better than trying to hit the high 90s.
3-1, and he couldn't come up with it. Next, the switch hitting first baseman, Carlos Santana.
Santana.
Runner on the goal. That one fouled off. Next one misses. 1-1. And the pitch. and a count 1-2. Winker, the runner at first, with one gone in the inning. Swing and a high fly ball, pretty well struck right field, way back there. Gone! Carlos Santana powers one out. It's his 8th home run of the year, and we are starting over. It's 7-7.
Anytime you have a pitch down the middle of the plate, the percentages go up for the hitter to do damage, even if it's a pretty good sinker like that one. Nice piece of hitting there at the plate.
Now the Diamondbacks manager is out of the dugout, and he'll make a move to the pen. Merrill Kelly, done for the day, and as he heads off, we'll step aside for a minute. Back with the new pitcher after this break. Pitching change here. Edwin Uceta. This is his 5th appearance of the year.
Number 66. Edwin Uceta.
Hey, Eugenio Suarez up to hit now. He's already homered here in this one.
The third baseman.
He swings and hits a fly ball. Center field. Brings it in, and there's two down.
Up next for Seattle, the shortstop, J.P.
Two outs, base is empty. Crawford. And up next for Seattle, J.P. Crawford. First offering misses the mark. The Diamondbacks with some movement in the pen. Kyle Nelson preparing to come on if needed. Smith getting cranked up as well. Swing and a high fly ball left field. Peralta makes the catch, and that'll do it. But two come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this two-run homer. And we're deadlocked here at 7-7. Back here at the ballpark, top 6. And now the switch hitting catcher, Jose Herrera.
The catcher, number 36. Jose Herrera.
And a pitch. That misses. 1-0.
Counts 1-0.
You'll throw that up, ball!
The pitch. That misses the zone. And that's ball 2. And he deals. Pitch misses, and that's ball 3. And the right-hander deals. Out to center, Rodriguez under it, and there's one down.
Now batting, the third baseman, Josh Rojas.
So the lineup flips over. Now up next for Arizona, Josh Rojas. He's already homered in this game. That one's in there, 0-1. Next offering is way upstairs. Here comes a pitch. That one drifts inside. The count 2-1. Next offering misses down and away.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with a 3-1 count.
Now front, pulls that one foul. Now it's 3-2. Swung on, belted. That's back. Pulls it in on the warning track.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
And stepping in is the speedy Alec Thomas. That one misses in the dirt.
Ball one, no strike.
The next offering misses. Now 2-0.
2-0.
At the belt and fires. In the air, left side. That's down. One hops off the wall. And that's a double.
Putting some good swings on the ball. That's his second extra base hit in this one. Pitch was away, and he did exactly what you're supposed to do with it. Drive it the other way. Just go with the pitch. A chance now to take the lead, and at this point in the game, that could be a deciding run.
Next is the DH, a switch hitter, Ketel Marte. In the air to left center. And that is that. 7-8-9, two up in the home half of the inning. And we are tied 7-7. Bottom of the sixth inning. And the batter now, Cal Raleigh.
Way to go.
So both sides equally as strong. So not a good time to try to turn him around with a relief pitcher and put him on the other side of the plate.
Buceta back to work. And ball one. Activity in the Arizona bullpen. Luke Weaver up and throwing. Middleton warming up as well. Next offering is in for a strike.
Ball one strike.
The 1-1. Hard hit left side. Rojas throws on to first. Leadoff man retired in the sixth.
Now back, the second baseman, Adam Frazier.
Adam Frazier up next for the Mariners. First pitch doesn't find the zone.
Count 1-0.
And here it comes.
Here we go.
And there's the strike. The wind of the pitch. Lined, and that's a base hit.
Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
One down. Sam Haggerty digs in now. First offering, and it just misses. Here's the pitch. Runner on the goal. Walker. Fired to second. Back to first. Double play. And that's it for the inning. We're through six full. And we are tied 7-7. Tommy Malone on to pitch here. This southpaw's been really good against left-handed hitters.
Tommy.
Whoa. And welcome back. We go to the top of the seventh. And now the first baseman, Christian Walker.
He's a big, strong guy. Can untie this game with one swing.
And a pitch. Up the middle. Frazier on to first in time. And they get the leadoff hitter in the seventh.
Now batting, left fielder, David Peralta.
Now at the plate, David Peralta.
Let's go, Mariners!
And the first pitch misses for ball one. Activity in the bullpen. Andres Munoz, a right-hander with big strikeout stuff, is getting it fired up. Kicks and deals. And that one just missed off the outside edge. Left-hand hitter waits. Fouled off to the right. Kicks and fires. In the air, pretty deep out to center field. Rodriguez has a beat on it. Calls it in, and there's two away.
Now batting, right fielder, Dalton Varsho.
And now Dalton Varsho, 1-for-3. And that's in there for strike one.
Man, I mean, nice job just presenting it to be better than it actually was.
Swing and a ball lifted to center field. Dives, but it's off his glove. Base hit. Throws to second. In there. Just beat the tag. It's a double.
You got to get on your horse, get to that thing, and get it back in, because he's going to come barrel around first. He's going to put pressure on you. If you bobble it or you don't get there in a hurry, he's going to make you look silly and end up on second base.
Go ahead, run on base. And now it's the switch hitting second baseman, Sergio Alcantara. Slap card the other way, but foul. Two down, go ahead, run in scoring position. And that one goes straight to the backstop. Varsho up to third on the wild pitch. Next one is off the plate. Two balls and a strike. Big swing and a miss. In the air, right field. Haggerty settles underneath it. He's got it. And that is out number three.
A lot of adrenaline. We can see it right there. And sometimes you just got to let it out. That's an outstanding job of taking that, executing, and getting out of a tough inning.
Back at T-Mobile Park, ready to go for the last half of the inning. And now the center fielder, Julio Rodriguez.
The center fielder, Julio Rodriguez.
The wind of the pitch. And that one just misses, a ball and no strikes. Next pitch is outside. Right-handed reliever. And that one missing low.
I almost feel like he's frustrated a little bit. He wants to be challenged.
The Hawaii to kick the pitch. And there's the strike. Hawaii to the pitch. Hits softly on the ground to third. And he picks it up and he'll put it in his pocket. And the pitch. It's a leadoff walk. And that's the go-ahead run.
Well, that's a really dangerous base runner to put on first, especially in a tie game. Now there might be some consequences coming from that mistake.
No outs. Runner at first. Ty France will hit next. In there for strike one.
If you're a base runner, you've got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get in the scoring position.
Right-hander kicks, deals.
One and one.
Busetta with a move to first. And he's back in standing. The go-ahead run aboard at first. Nobody out. Next offering is in for a strike.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, try to stay out of a double play here.
Next offering misses. It's 2-2. The pitch. Fly ball to right. And that'll fall for a base hit. Throw holds him at second, but the go-ahead run now in scoring position, and still nobody out.
Well, that was an important bat in this game, so great job there stepping up to the challenge.
With the way defenders track down balls these days, I mean, both from the infield and in the outfield, there really aren't a lot of base hits on balls hit like that. But there's always a little room back behind the first and second baseman to drop a lot.
Now a high fly ball out to left center. And it hops over the wall for an automatic double as a run scores on the play.
Well, everyone is thinking, Ed, would the runner have scored from first if the ball stayed in the park? We'll never know, but they do get a run across with a chance to do more damage in the inning.
Carlos Santana up next for the Mariners.
Now batting, first baseman, Carlos Santana.
And a foul ball left side. Righty to the plate. Slapped foul. Oh and two now. And that skips in the dirt. Two runners in scoring position. Nobody out. Next offering is foul back. Left-hand batter waits. Here's a high chopper. Sends it to first and one away in the bottom of the seventh.
Now batting, third baseman, Eugenio Suarez.
And now here is Eugenio Suarez.
Looking for some insurance, or as our friends down in the South would say,
insurance.
No matter how you say it, we know what you mean.
The pitch just misses the mark outside the zone.
One ball, two strikes.
Pitch. And now it's even up.
Great job of laying off those pitches down in the zone to even the count up at 2-2. Such a better feeling for the hitter.
Next pitch just misses, and the count's full. Right through there, got him. Now two out.
Big strikeout right there, and that kind of takes the pressure off the defense a bit. Infield was in, so now they can move back, give themselves more time on a grounder to make the play. A lot more ways to work out of this and strand that runner at third now.
And stepping in for the Mariners, J.P. Crawford. Pulled hard, but it's a foul ball. Two as he waves at that one. Two outs, two in scoring position. Sharp grounder, that's through for a base hit. One run is in. Now a long throw home. It's off the mark and he scores. And they're up by three.
Well, he found himself behind in the count right there, but he didn't give in. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch, just shot it through the infield.
So out of the pen for the Diamondbacks, Luke Weaver. Now he last pitched 2 days ago.
Number seven, Luke Weaver.
Raleigh stands in now and watches strike one. And the pitch. That misses the zone, and now it's even 1-1. And the pitch. Inside just missed. Crawford off of first with two away. The pitch. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Fought off foul. Three. Down on strikes. Good job at damage control right there. Eighth inning coming up. It's the Mariners 10 and the Diamondbacks 7.
Bounce it, just bounce it. Everybody wanna come, I'm announcing it. I'm always gonna get it, I'm always gonna get it. Even if you sit.
New pitcher now, Diego Castillo. And he'll do his best to hang on to this lead.
Leading off for Arizona, the shortstop, Geraldo.
The wind of the pitch. Perdomo leading things off and takes a strike. Some activity in the Mariners' bullpen. Paul Sewald, the anchor of the staff, is getting ready to close this one out. Next offering down in the dirt. Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, it's critical right here that they bear down and turn in some quality at bats, try to chip away at that lead, because if it gets to the ninth, that closer's coming in.
Next offering way off the plate. 2-2 down. Hopped up. Crawford moving under it and puts the squeeze on that one. One down.
Oh, that's a frustrating end to the at bat for the hitter right there. I mean, that pitch was right down the middle. I think he got a little too excited, came out of his mechanics, and instead of driving that ball somewhere, he popped it up. Unfortunate for him.
That one is absolutely belted. Bangs off the wall. Crawford, relay to second. Not in time, it's a double.
Well, a swing like that can help you come out of the struggle. We saw the numbers coming into the ball game. But all he's trying to do at this point is help his team win.
So back to the top of the Arizona lineup. Here's Josh Rojas. Ripped on the ground a second. Oh, what a stop. Gathers and throws, and that's a great play for the out.
Well, you can see right there, he looks very comfortable going to the backhand. Nice diving stop, gets up to complete the play. That'll fire the boys up for sure.
Alec Thomas stands in now for the Diamondbacks.
Really good piece of hitting last time going to the opposite field.
In there, and it's 0-1.
Got to keep things airtight defensively right here. On your toes, ready to make a play. If you can get this to the ninth with a three-run lead, it should be a W.
On the ground. That's a base hit as a run scores.
Well done. Narrows the deficit with the RBI there. Everyone's trying to elevate the ball in today's game, but if you can hit a ball that hard on the ground, it's going to find some holes. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
And next is the Diamondbacks DH, Ketel Marte. That one's in there, 0-1. Castillo a throw over, and he's back in easily. And the 0-1. Now 1-1.
I got one ball, one strike.
The pitch. On a line out towards center. That's a base hit. And that'll put runners at the corners with two away.
Really nice job of two-strike hitting in that at bat. Just a very nice approach and swing right there to use the big part of the field. Everything was on time. He stayed balanced through the entire swing and just launched that one into center. Now a huge at bat in this game coming up.
Now it's going to be Christian Walker. This to third. They take the force out, and that will end the inning. But the RBI single pushes across a run. It's down to two at 10-8 now. Back in Seattle, here's the second baseman, Adam Frazier.
Leading up for the Mariners, the second baseman.
And a pitch.
Frazier.
Just missed. The Diamondbacks with some movement in the pen. Caleb Smith, the left-handed reliever, appears to be getting loose. And the 1-0. Just missed. Righty delivers. Swing and a ball lifted left field. High bounce over the fence for an automatic double.
Well, there's something really nice about getting yourself an automatic double like that. You get to stroll into second base without having to worry about a throw or getting your uniform dirty. And now you're just looking for the next guy to kind of do the same thing. Maybe put one in the gap so you can jog home as well.
Digging in is the switch inning outfielder, Sam Haggerty. And that one is lifted in the air. Makes the grab. Runner tags up for third. And he makes it up to third with one away.
Now back, the center fielder, Julio.
Back to the top of the Seattle order. Here's the Mariners leadoff man, Julio Rodriguez.
Here's the sack fly situation, and he's got to make sure he gets the ball out over the plate and get those arms extended. They're trying to crowd him with the infield in. This would be a big pickup if he could push a run across.
And he deals. Now a screamer into the outfield and makes the grab. Runner tags from third. Play it home. He's safe. It's 11-8.
Sometimes that can be a little tough to score on. It just hits so hard that getting back to the bag to tag takes a little bit of time by the time that outfielder catches it, but a really good job of getting that run in from third.
Two outs, base is empty. Now here is Ty France. Good contact guy, good defender. Little bouncer out in front of the plate, and he picks it up in foul territory. That one misses, and that is ball one. Here comes a pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. That one just misses.
And that's awfully close. I don't know how you take that. He's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well right now.
Next pitch is in the dirt. Full count now. And here it comes. Turned on, but that's foul down the third baseline.
Well, he's ready for that fastball right there. Really turned on it. Hit it hard. Had the distance. Just too much hook to it, so nothing.
This one squared up down the left field line. If it's fair, it's gone. It's fair, and it is gone. Ty France goes deep, and they add a run. It's 12-8.
Well, you can never fault the guy for going after a hitter in a 3-2 count. He tried to challenge him, but just didn't have enough to get it by him. Really good swing, a nice home run.
So digging in, Jesse Winker.
Now batting, left fielder, Jesse.
Next pitch is popped up, and that's a foul ball. Oh, and one now. And that one in the air center field. Thomas under it. He makes the grab. And that is that. Through eight full, it's the Mariners 12 and the Diamondbacks 8. We're back. It's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, number 56.
Number 56.
And he'll work on holding this lead.
Murphy.
Back here at the ballpark at the plate, David Peralta.
Leading off for the Diamondbacks.
The left fielder, David Peralta.
The pitch. And first offering is fouled off. At the belt and fires. And now the count is even. Bullpen activity starting up now. Eric Swanson getting ready to go.
Let's go, Bears.
The 1-1.
So far, all we've seen in this at bat are fastballs. Look for him to slow it down right here ahead in the count.
Down and in, moved his feet. The 2-2. And another ball. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Looked like a questionable call in that spot. He even seemed a little surprised it went his way at the plate, but as a hitter, you'll take that all day.
Now it's the right fielder, Dalton Varsho.
Well, the leadoff man gets on. You want to minimize the threat by playing sound defense. Hopefully the pitcher can get a ball on the ground and they can roll him up for two.
And the right-hander deals. Swung on. Popped up on the infield. Frazier should have this one. And there's one away.
The batter, the second baseman, Sergio Alcantara.
Sergio Alcantara stands in now for the Diamondbacks. First pitch just misses. Peralta, the base runner at first with one out. Next pitch is outside. Two balls, no strikes, the count. And that one fouled off. And the righty deals. Swing and a miss. And now 2-2.
Man, he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
The next pitch misses. 3-2 now. Hit well, right field, way back, and gone. An absolutely majestic shot. His second of the year. It's 12-10.
When you have a team that hits home runs at such a high rate, they can get back in the ballgame so quickly. That's why that leadoff walk was extremely costly.
Paul Sewald comes on now. He's being eased into the game here with the bases empty.
Paul Sewald.
Geraldo Perdomo stands in now for the Diamondbacks.
Geraldo Perdomo.
And first offering is fouled off.
Hey, partner, how's your scorecard looking right now?
A little dicey, kind of hieroglyphics style at the moment. You know what it's like, Sammy? Remember our trip to London, Yankees and Red Sox in 2019? I think there were, 50 runs scored in the two games combined. My scorecard was ugly for that series.
Next pitch, way upstairs.
The 1-1. In there at the knees for a strike.
Yeah, pretty ridiculous. And you use like 5 different colors of pens, so like it's just a mosaic over there.
Yeah, I mean, I know you're always judging the different pens. Like, you know, I get the skinny scoring pen, and then I have the red, and then the black, and then I got a highlighter. So there is a lot going on.
Now the catcher, Jose Herrera.
Now the catcher up to hit, Jose Herrera. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Two down, nobody on.
If you're the pitcher, you've got to go right at this guy. It's the number 9 hitter in the lineup. You can't be afraid of contact in this situation.
Next pitch misses, and it's 3-0.
Pressure mountain right here with the tying run in the on-deck circle. He's got to find the strike zone.
Just one out away, trying to close it out. That just missed. He walked him on 4 pitches. Here's the third baseman, Josh Rojas. First pitch, and he just misses. This one rip, but foul to the right. The tying run at the plate. And now one strike away. In the air out to center, Rodriguez drifts towards it. He's got it. Ball game. And the Mariners slug their way to a win in this one.
Well, this was a total team effort using 6 pitchers in this ball game to get the win. Outstanding job of passing the baton. The next guy stepping up and getting it done. You got to give him a lot of credit because this is not easy to do. We'll see how it affects them over the next couple of days.
And your final, 12-10. Chris Singleton and our entire crew. I'm John Schauble saying so long.
And 56 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.